If you are a writer or a world builder, I have a book to recommend to you. It'll help you build more believable characters and a more immersive world. Keep watching. Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of the Other Epic Story Vlog. This is the show where I talk about writing, editing, world building tips and tricks and apply it to my own work, which is an epic trilogy that I'm working on. If you want to find out more about this project, I got a link right up there for you. You can watch older episodes if this is your first time here. If not, let's get right to the point. So this book isn't new at all, but I feel like it's found me at the right time. And the book I'm talking about is Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind by Yuval Noah Harari. You might have seen this book around. I'm actually listening to the audiobook version right now. Not right now, but I am listening to it. And I just want to sum up a few points that I think will help you create a more immersive world. There's a lot to this book. It goes way back to the dawn of mankind and talks about the days when Homo erectus and Neanderthals roamed the world, and it had a really interesting theory about how the Homo sapiens actually wiped out all those other human species just with their pure brutality. From there, they talked about humans being hunter-gatherers and how much healthier and fulfilling and happy their life was back then when it was just so simple. You know, you go out, you get food, and then literally there was so much chilling involved. So from being hunter-gatherers until the agricultural revolution, we start to see that humans are creating all these imaginary concepts, from religions to businesses to social class to justice to money. And that is where I realize these are the things that when you're world building, you can modify these imaginary things. Human as, you know, a humanoid will always remain the same, but it is the stories that we tell. It is the beliefs that we have that are constantly changing. In a way, even if you're building a world in modern day world, you could actually create a group of people with different sets of beliefs. And that in itself is world building. You could world build by having geography, by having history, by having all that stuff. But in the end, it comes down to what the people living in the world actually believe, what stories they're telling each other. And I think that is a really good place to start if you are world building. Pick any of those elements, any of those imaginary stories, and expand on it. Be creative with it. How do these people, how does currency work in this world? How does justice work in this world? Is there a social class system? Is there gender equality? That's why I feel that Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind, this book is such a good creative jumpstart for world builders, because there's so much, it gives you so much to think about and to work with. Even now, our beliefs in this world that we're living in is constantly changing, and it's just fascinating seeing how people react to it. And just that way of people thinking that each person is so different now, that although we have all these overarching beliefs, there's so many little things that separate us. And there's so many things to believe now that we're all constructed out of our own stories that we tell ourselves, our own experiences. And although there's religion, there's currency, the idea that the only reason money is valuable is because someone else thinks that it is valuable, or that the only reason we feel comfortable within a community is because we have this belief in justice, in law, and that if we do something wrong, we will be punished for it. So that's just me mind dumping all the ideas that I sort of accumulated from this book that I just really wanted to share with you guys. And if you're finding yourself in a slump, or having writer's block, or in a rut of some sort, and you don't know how to make this world a little bit more vibrant, I really recommend this book, Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind. Yuval Noah Harari is the author. If you dig listening to audiobooks as much as I do, I really like them, especially if they're nonfiction. I find that nonfiction books are the best for consuming through your ears, just listening to them when you're commuting, when you're walking your dog, when you're just trying to ignore the world. It's such a good way to escape and learn something new through audiobooks. I have an affiliate link down below for the book if you want to try out Audible. Give it a shot. I hope this helps. I hope this inspires you. I hope you got some good takeaways from today of what you could work with when you are building out a world. And I know this book, I'm really gonna start applying it to my own work. I'm gonna start breaking down everything that my world kind of believes, these stories, that these like overarching elements, and really work on them, flesh them out a little bit more, and have a more immersive world for you guys to explore soon. If you want to know the three rules to world building, please check it out. I have a video right up there. It'll show you the mechanics that you need to understand when you're building out a world and telling a story. I'll see you in that video. Hang loose, everybody. Hang loose.